Hello friends, this is Yusuf here. Today we are going to see a couple of things, and before that I would highlight that most of the people are asking the public 400 server is down, so how do we practice from our home, etc. So as I have posted some comments that we have this texas400.com domain which is offering us a $25 approximately 1800 Indian rupees for 3 months subscription. So I have just got that user ID password, so I'm just going to log in with that. This is a Texas 400 server. Okay, so the user ID they have given is user 432 and there is a password given as well. So it's good, and it's a v6r1 environment, and display user prf user 432, and I'm also having 100 MB of storage. I think for a programmer, just to practice, this is good enough. I will keep using for a few weeks and then let you know how it works in the performance wise. Okay, so now let's go to the today's topic. Today I want to cover few things on the developer's point of view, like some of the debugging tips and other some interesting tips. So let's get started. Okay, the first one is, many of us know the display keyword in the RPGLE is used to display a string or a value during the program execution, right? So can we get input from the user? Okay, like during the execution of the program should ask for the input, and we should give the input manually, and then it should run based on that. Luckily, the display keyword itself will help us to get the input. So when I say this, I would like to give an example. So number 21. So I have a program, so I would like to compile it first, RPG01R. So if we call RPG01R, you can see it's asking for enter the number 1, so I say 10, then enter the number 2, I say 15, and then we see the value is 25. So how this happens? So if you go inside, okay, this is a program. So we have defined two numbers, and what we know, like, okay, we know to display a string or a variable, right? But you can give the variable next to it to receive the response from the user also. So the syntax is something like this. So we can give the string which you want to display, and there should be an empty space. Actually, this place is to give whether it's an interactive job or a bad job. Interactive job means star ext, or if it's batch, then qsysopr kind of stuff. But you can leave it blank so that the program will automatically determine what it is, and then we can receive, or you can define a variable to receive the number, and then that's it. It works. So I hope it helps. So the next tip what we are going to see is, yesterday one of my friend asked, like, if you have a very big variable, say for example a 3000 character, 4000 character, during debugging mode, if we display that thing, right, we can only see 1024 character. So let me show an example for that. Okay, so here I have a one string containing a length of 2000 character, and I am assigning a value of high, so it will occupy the first two position, and you can see I am extracting the substring from 1500 to the 10 position, and I am assigning y. So if you want to display this variable during debugging, what happens? So we're just gonna see it. So let me compile it using whatever the source mode. Then if I see it, you can see it both assigned, and if I press here F11, I can only see high. If I come down, only I can see up to 1024. So how to see the remaining stuff? Because basically we have this by text also resides inside. So for this, what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to design have another data structure, okay, as a work with overlay. Okay, so here's what I was explaining. So we have this one string, so I'm going to have a temporary data structure, okay, which is having a field called tempstr, which is have length 1000, okay, but I'm having it as an array of 2, so which means on the total this will be 2000. Okay, so let's see what happens if I try to assign this big string to this temp variable. So I am doing it here. Okay, let us debug this. Sorry, So now these two is getting assigned, and here also assigned. So if you go click here, so you can see, right, the high is displayed. If you come down, the second thing, we have the buy available. So in this way we can see, so basically during debugging, only in the case of any analysis required, we can introduce these temporary things to see how it works. Okay, and then that is going to be a third tip. Okay, the third one is actually regarding pointers. So you all know about pointers. I had made one video before. You can get the link from the description box. So if you know the pointer, if you want to display the pointer variable in debugging, we'll see only that SPP colon some address. Okay, so can we get the actual value also from the variable? So we're gonna see that. So let me quickly write one small program. Okay, here is the code. We can see we have a small variable called string having 10 length, and we are assigning a value to that string. And then we also have a pointer called p underscore str. Star is the type to denote the pointer. And we have another variable file length, and we say this variable is based on this pointer. Okay, and wherever this pointer is pointing to the memory location, the value can be retrieved from this particular variable. And here what we are doing here, once we assign this value to this str, we are taking this address of this str. It should be str, okay, and then assigning to this pointer. So let's see what happens here. Sorry. Okay, as you know, we are coming here. So now this is having the hello world. Just because the length is 10, we cannot have more than 10 assigned. And then the next thing is pointer. So now if you see this pointer, we see some ununderstandable value, but this is pointer is based on this particular variable. So if you see here, we'll be seeing the first 5 of this str, because now this pointer is pointing to the first address of this str variable, which is the h part, and from there we are displaying only the 5. Okay, now the question is, can we see this with this pointer itself? Okay, because if I press F11, we are seeing some address. So how to see that means, we have to give a colon C space length. So this is a syntax. If we do that, I'll be able to see what is the value which the pointer contains. Now you can think of, pointer is just a pointer, right, and length is just a length. So what if I give 10? So I want to see from this pointer to the 10 length. You can see the full thing is coming. So even though this variable p underscore data is having length 5, but this pointer is pointing to this particular string, so we can see with the help of this pointer the remaining stuff also. Now think something different. What will happen if I give 20? Okay, and you will be having some junk, because that is not data signed, so that may have be a system variable or whatever. So see the junk. So this is how we'll be we can see pointer's data here, using this particular syntax of C. So I hope this helps, these 3 tips, and I'll catch you in the next video with some other topics. Thanks for watching.